Lausanne and Switzerland, a meeting of the Executive Commission of the International Olympic Committee. And one of its members, the first vice president, is Nawal El Moutawakel, the Moroccan student athlete who went on to become one of the world's most respected leaders in sport. University was fundamental. Without that academic passage, I would never be what I am today. Nawal rose to fame in 1984 at the Los Angeles Olympics in the 400 meters hurdles. She became the first African female Olympic champion. She'd been training at the University of Iowa in the USA because there was a lack of opportunity in her own country. I could win at any time in Morocco because I was alone, really, in the 400 meters hurdles, which was a new event for women at that time. We were, what, two, three, four athletes running the 400? And as I knew I was going to win, I just trotted to the finish line. But when I first arrived in the USA, there were thousands of women who ran better than me or like me. And so you really had to be competitive. It was necessary to fight hard every time, to run until you were exhausted in order to snatch that first place. For Nawal, the United States presented a new language, a new culture, and a world of striving for excellence. It would form her character, a character put to the test almost as soon as she landed there. I lost my father a week after I arrived in the USA, that is. I learned about it several weeks later because they hid it from me. Because, well, precisely, they didn't want me to become depressed that the dream of becoming an Olympic champion could have evaporated, so it was kept secret from me. A few weeks before the Games, Nawal had to make a choice, whether to quit or to push on in memory of her father.
I decided to stay here for 4 years or longer, I don't know. But if I did return back home, I would make a big mistake.
All this created an electric shock in my head, if you like, and I said, well, that's just the way it is. You know, sometimes we might give up, but often we can excel because everything is working to prepare yourself mentally, psychologically, and physically to continue to move forward. Despite losing her father and adjusting to issues like the cold weather, Nawal knew that America offered a university course that could transform her life. I had to excel in athletics, of course, which is what I wanted, but it was also necessary for me to excel in academic studies in order to deserve the scholarship I got. So my effort was really a double one, because I not only had to first of all master English and then work by translating what I wanted in my head every time, but also to go ahead and to deserve to be in the track and field team. There was no internet, no tablets at that time, so we were always with a school bag full of working papers because the distances between different states are huge. So we were all the time leaning on our books, always had the lights on in the coaches with our highlighters because we knew, regardless of the time and the place you were in, the next examinations were set for a certain date, and you couldn't say to your professor, excuse us, we were in a competition. The challenge for Nawal was to continually reach the academic level required to stay at the university because, in terms of sport, certainly, she was outstanding, even becoming the captain of the Cyclones, the university athletics team, one of the best of them, in fact, in the United States. Often they call me Sirocco of Morocco because when I ran, I won everything, the 100, 200, 400, 4x100, all the events. And so they said, oh, no, not her, not the Moroccan again. They'd already lost, even before they started to compete. But there was a spirit of extraordinary solidarity. We spoke the same language, we had the same spirit, the same purpose, the same objective, which was to win the NCAA title every time. Nawal was crowned university champion in the United States several times. So it was natural that she take part in the Universiade, the World University Games. She took gold at Kobe in Japan in 1985 and 2 years later won her second title in Zagreb. For us, it was really like a party, a celebration, getting together as students and seeing how each and every one of us had evolved in the right direction, intellectually, at all levels. So for me, it was an unmissable event to every time represent my country first and somewhere my American university indirectly. And nowadays, you know, when I look back, when I look at the photos, I still think today how nice it was, what a good time it was. But Nawal would put an end to her athletics career following a terrible tragedy which shook the university, leaving her alone once again, a catastrophic plane crash. It was a real tragedy. I could have gone along as team captain, but I was not called that time. Somebody woke me up, I remember, one night in November, and I learned the bad news. There was a plane that had crashed, and the whole university team had been killed. Well, I decided, I said to myself, I'm going to quit. I was surrounded by people who were the most dear to me, my father, my coaches, the American team, and all those people had disappeared. 30 years on, the emotion is still there. But Nawal El Moutawakel would see her life take a distinct turn for the better with the help of the president of FISU, Primo Nebbiolo. In the early 1990s, the Olympic Congress in Paris, which coincided with the introduction of a special quota for women in international institutions, gave me a little hope. And accompanied by Primo Nebbiolo and Lamine Diak and Samaranch, well, they brought me into this world that was totally new to me, a world I had to discover. Nawal became a figurehead for African women, a leader of a movement for the emancipation of women through sport. Somewhere, I felt a huge sense of pride to have taken part in pushing this door that was a little bit closed in the minds of some people, to understand that there are Muslim, Arab, African women who could also find their place at the international level. She became a member of the International Athletics Federation, the IAAF, in 1995, and then a member of the IOC in 1998, largely thanks to the time she'd spent at university. Education is important, and a university course is even more important. And I think that's the background. It's a formidable weapon that can help you forge your path and follow your career. Today's athletes, tomorrow's leaders. Nawal El Moutawakel is the perfect illustration of the slogan of FISU.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.